From the moment we're conceived, our genes encode in us every instruction our bodies will ever need. These genes build our organs, our muscle, our brains. They help us grow and keep us healthy. But the tiniest deviations also make us sick. Many of us are carrying these deviations without ever knowing it. And this woman wants to find those problems early, before it becomes too late.
My name is Carrie Blout, and I'm a preventive genetic counselor.
We are here to celebrate the completion of the first survey of the entire human genome. With this profound new knowledge, humankind is on the verge of gaining immense new power to heal.
In the early 2000s, scientists decoded the first human genome. Since then, we've discovered the genetic footprint of thousands of illnesses. And if you have a health problem or come from a family with health problems, your doctor might have ordered a DNA test to diagnose and treat you. But it's only very recently that hospitals have started screening the genomes of seemingly healthy people. Healthy people like me. The goal of these screenings is the holy grail of modern medicine: to map each person's risk of disease in order to treat conditions early or prevent them from ever developing. Today, I'm heading to Boston to get my own DNA screened.
In our studies, we're finding that there's 10 to 15% of people walking around that we would expect to either have symptoms of a condition now or to develop it in the future.
Carrie has a master's degree in genetic counseling. 4 years ago, she joined a research program affiliated with Brigham and Women's Hospital and Harvard Medical School. The program has been screening the genomes of healthy people, and through her research, Carrie's helped more than 100 patients make sense of their results.
Sometimes I'm telling them really scary stuff that they just weren't anticipating. One example is a woman who had a variant for breast cancer. She had no idea she was at risk. She got screening for that and actually found out she had early breast cancer, which she wouldn't have been found to have that early anyway, if we had not initiated things.
Early findings like this prompted Brigham to quietly open the Preventive Genomics Clinic in November last year.
So why does she want to be tested? Really, what's her motivation here?
It's led by geneticist Dr. Robert Green, and Carrie has seen its first few patients. It's one of the world's only clinics offering DNA testing for preventative purposes. I'm here to become its seventh ever patient.
Hi, Aki.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Okay. Before we get started, can you tell me a little bit about what drew you to this clinic and why you're interested in preventive genomics?
I thought about it a lot, and if there's something that I can prevent, then I think I'd rather know now.
Okay.
So I'm a little worried I'm opening a Pandora's box.
Okay.
But yeah, I'm excited to do this.
Carrie is trained to guide patients through the complicated world of DNA testing. And that starts with helping patients choose the right tests. You might have even tried one of them you can take at home, like 23andMe. But 23andMe looks at less than 1% of your genome to identify your risk of developing just 13 conditions. The workup I'm getting will sequence virtually my entire genome, placing a special focus on about 3,700 genes that are associated with more than 2,500 conditions. Which means if I go through with this test, I could find out a whole lot more.
How would you feel if you found out that you were at risk for something that we didn't currently have a treatment for that you might develop later in life?
Even if I knew now that I'd only live till 40, mm-hmm. I think I'd want to know that so I can plan my life around that. I'd want to make sure that my wife would be okay after I died, and I think I'd still want to know.
Great, and you're exactly the type of patient that we want to see in this clinic. Some people really just don't want to know, and some people are really information seekers and want all the information that they can get. So this is a good test for you.
Open your mouth wide, say ah. You're just going to check your reflexes.
And after Dr. Green checked in,
take a seat here.
I got my blood drawn. For all this, my bill today will be just over $4,000, which includes this hospital visit, as well as the cost to sequence my DNA and analyze it. It's a lot, since most of it isn't covered by insurance. But take a look at how much the cost of sequencing has come down over the last two decades. This is why genetic testing has become so widely available, and why the professionals who help patients make sense of them are now in such high demand. Salaries have soared, with genetic counselors earning a median $80,000 last year. That's more than twice the median pay in the US.
Great, you're all done. Your results will take about 2 to 3 months to get back, so we'll give you a call and set up that follow-up appointment for when they're ready.
And while I settled back into my life in San Francisco, machines extracted the DNA from the nuclei of my cells. Then more machines read the 6 billion base pairs that make up that DNA, which geneticists then analyzed for clues of disease. Then, 2 months later.
Hi, this is Carrie Blout calling. Your genome report should be back soon, so I wanted to schedule an appointment to see you for results. If you could give me a call back when you have a chance, thank you.
And I made my way back to Boston.
When I'm returning results to patients, there's not always a treatment or a cure for something that we find. And those conversations are very difficult because we're telling them something that could affect their life. And I think the most difficult part is when someone is really stressed and I can't make it better. It can be very hard. But you're also helping them. And that overpowers any of the challenges of the job.
Hi,
Aki. How are you? Good to see you again. Good to see you, too. Let's go to my office. Sure. So I want to reassure you, we didn't find anything that's scary.
Oh, what a relief.
Let's go through what we did find. Mm-hmm. So the top report called monogenic disease findings, that would be if we found something in you right now that we thought might impact your health either now or in the near term future. Basically, we didn't find anything in that category.
Okay.
What we did find in you is that you have 3 carrier variants. This is the type of variant that when you go to have children, if the sperm had the same variant in it as your egg did, the child could have it.
I see.
One of the things that you're a carrier for is xeroderma pigmentosa. It is a photosensitivity condition, so you're very sensitive to sun. Even in mild sunlight, you could get blistering or burning in the sun. But for this gene, it's actually 1 in 4,000.
So 1 in 4,000 is the chance that my child will
have
this disease.
Have that condition, exactly. So pretty rare.
I was really nervous coming into this meeting today. But what do you think I should tell my wife?
I think you can tell her that it was good, that you had a boring genome, which is the kind that I like to see.
Yeah.
Before this goes mainstream, Carrie and her colleagues still have much to prove. Will the price of these tests be worth the lives they save? Will uncertain results make patients anxious? Will they lead to unnecessary procedures? But with enough research, this technology could become standard for all of us.
Maybe one day we'll all get sequenced, maybe even at birth, and have that information to inform our healthcare over time.
Then we'll have a lot more genetic counselors like Carrie, helping us prevent what we can and plan for what we can't. They'll guide us from one milestone to the next, through childhood. Adolescence and adulthood, all the way to old age.